谢谢你。
Yes, Lord, thank you.
愿我的一生荣耀主你的名。
Let my whole life glorify your name.
耶稣基督的启示。
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
不再隐藏。
It's no longer hidden.
透过我。
Through me.
彰显出来。
It's to be revealed.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
绕行的日子已经满足了。
It's the time we stop circling. The time is full.
所以主，我们不再绕行。
We will no longer circle.
主，当你宣告了。
When you declare it.
我们也凭着信心起行。
By faith, we start the journey again.
主，我们凭着信心起行。
By faith, we start.
主，我们带着我们的额头上有圣灵的印记。
We have the seal of the Holy Spirit on our forehead.
有耶稣基督的名。
As the name of Jesus.
我们更带着耶稣基督的宝血。
We carry the blood of Christ.
我们更是有叫耶稣基督从死里复活的圣灵。
Even more, we have the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
我们带着。
We carry.
神你的道。
Your word.
我们要走进神你所给我们的迦南地。
We will enter into the land of Canaan.
我们要得着那一地为业。
We will receive the promised land as our inheritance.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
谢谢主，你的名赐给了我们。
Thank you for giving us your name.
谢谢主，你将你的宝血赐给了我们。
Thank you for giving us your blood.
谢谢主，你的宝血跟我们所立的新约。
Thank you for the new covenant in your blood.
也谢谢那叫耶稣基督从死里复活的灵住在我们的里面。
Thank you for the spirit that lives inside of us that also raised Jesus from the dead.
所以我们带着这样子神的话。
So we carry the word of God.
带着真理。
Carry the truth.
我们要成为这一地的光。
We shall be the light in this land.
我们也要成为这一地的见证。
We shall be the testimony in this land.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 我们将荣耀归给我们的主。
Glory be unto our God.
Hallelujah. 所以感谢赞美主的恩典。
Praise the Lord for His grace.
就像今天
like today,
的诗歌所唱的
like what we sing today during worship
荣耀羔羊耶稣
Glory to the Lamb, Jesus
也愿这成为我们一个很重要的开始
Let this be an important beginning for us as well
因为最近牧师一直不断地听到的
Because I kept hearing recently
就是说绕行的日子已经够了
The time that we circle around is full
就是我们之前有宣告在生命记第二章
In Deuteronomy 2
在那里牧师5781年有宣告出来
I declare in 5781
就是绕行的日子已经够了
It's enough that we circled
绕行日子满足的意思就是我们要进去得地为业
The time is full meaning that we shall enter in and as an inheritance
所以我们是带着耶稣基督的宝血
so we,
我们是带着耶稣基督的名
So we carry the name of Jesus
我们的额头上是有耶稣基督的名
We have the name of Jesus on our forehead
我们有耶稣基督宝血跟我们所立的新约
We have the new covenant in his blood
我们的里面住着那叫耶稣基督从死里复活者的灵
We have the spirit that raised Jesus from the dead
然后
And
我们有神的话
We have the word of God
所以当我们有这样子的时刻我们可以兴起
So in this time we can arise
现在是兴起的时刻
It is the time to arise
所以兴起
So arise
代表着我们要得地为业
Means we will enter this land and have it as an inheritance
Amen 所以牧师今天要来讲的记得我有当 Pastor Philip 分享的时候
So when Pastor Philip shared before
他说在前的将要在后
He said the first shall be last
然后在后的将要在前
And the last first
所以这个经文记载在马太福音
的第19章 19
29到30节前面牧师就不再读了
29 to 30
我只读后面 29-30。在这里19章
verse, chapter 19,
29-30。
29-30。
凡为我名撇下房屋或是弟兄姐妹、父亲母亲、田地的必要得着百倍，并且承受永生。然而许多在前的将要在后，在后的将要在前。
Matthew 19:29。And everyone who has left the houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my name's sake shall receive a hundredfold and inherit an eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last first.
这里很明显的，这里是耶稣回答彼得。
Here Jesus was answering Peter.
因为彼得就是这个年轻富有的少年官，忧忧愁愁的走了。
Because this rich young ruler, he went away sorrowfully.
然后彼得就说，那我们呢？我们已经为了你撇下所有的一切。
And Peter said, how about us? We left everything for you.
然后我们已经跟从了你，我们要得着什么？
And we follow you, what else shall we receive?
然后耶稣就告诉了他，哦，就是到复兴的时候，人子坐在他荣耀的宝座上，你们也要坐在十二个宝座上，审判以色列十二个支派。
And Jesus said to them, assuredly I say to you, that in the regeneration, when the Son of Man sits on the throne of his glory, you who have followed me will also sit on the 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel.
然后再来就接着就是我刚刚所说的。
And then that follows whatever I said earlier.
但是牧师，很多的人不解，就在这里，主耶稣说，然而有许多的在前的将要在后，在后的将要在前。
But here Jesus said, but many who are first will be last, and the last first.
所以很多人在这里 就卡住了。这其实是圣经里面一个很困难解释的一节经文。
This is a difficult verse to interpret.
所以有很多的人试着要解释。
Many people try to interpret it.
因为在二十章，马太福音的二十章的第一节一直到十六节。
Because in Matthew 20 from verse 1 to 16,
耶稣就来解释这个。许多在前的将要在后，在后的将要在前。
And Jesus was explaining the first, last, and last first.
然后耶稣用的比喻就是，天国好像家主清早去雇人进他的葡萄园做工。
And the parable Jesus used is like for the kingdom of heaven is like the landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard.
然后他就一直讲解下来。
And he kept talking.
他讲定了，就是一天就是给一锭银子。
And then they say, oh, one day of labor is one.
一千银子 I'm sorry.
One day of labor is one denarius.
Okay. Denarius. 所以他就进去了。
So the worker entered.
然后就有不同的时间有人进去。
And a different time frame, the different workers will enter.
然后到了发薪水的时候。
Until the time is to give out the money.
然后他是从最后进来的人开始发。
And he started with the last person who entered.
然后所以最后也是给他一千银子。
And then he also received one denarius.
然后圣经描写说那最早进来的人在后面就想说，哦，那这样子我岂不是要得到更多吗？
But the first worker who enters like, oh, shouldn't I receive even more?
然后结果最后的这个人也拿到只是一千银子。
The person who entered last also received one denarius.
然后圣经这里就讲到说他就有点埋怨他的家主。
And then, so this worker is complaining to the vineyard owner.
在第十一节
in verse 11.
Okay, 然后他说我们整天劳苦受热，然后后来那个只做一个小时，然后他也得一千银子。
And he was complaining that the last men have worked only 1 hour, and you made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the and the heat of the day.
然后家主就回答说，朋友，我们没有亏负你啊，因为我们讲定了。
And the owner said, friend, I'm doing you no wrong. Did you not agree with me for a denarius?
然后最后耶稣又讲了这一句十六节。
And Jesus said in verse 16,
这样
so,
那在后的将要在前，在前的将要在后了。
So the last will be first and the first last.
然后那个小字那里古卷有加上说，因为被招的人多，选上的人少。
For many are called, but few are chosen. But few chosen.
哎，这样子的时候反而更不容易了解了。奇怪了，耶稣试着解释前面，可是我们听了以后反而更是一头雾水。
So Jesus was trying to explain what he said earlier, but now we're even more confused.
所以有很多人就讲说，哦，这个是讲救恩嘛。
So people say, oh, maybe it's talking about salvation.
不是 maybe 就是有的人
some people
大部分都解经就是说这里是救恩
a lot of people say this is talking about salvation
所以就是前面的进来跟后面进来都一样
so the first who enter and the last who enter is all the same
可是这里不是这样的意思啊
but this is not what it said here
他在这里讲说在前的要在后那在后的要在前
here it says the last will be first and the first last
而且又招的人多选上的人少
and even said for many are called but few are chosen
所以有很多人讲这个可能并不是如此
so many people say oh maybe it's not
那有的人就讲说哦这里是讲以色列在先我们外邦人在后
so some people say oh it's talking about Israelites and then the Gentiles
那这样子外邦人要胜过那以色列人、so、那以色列人又觉得这个似乎不是这样解的吧
so it's like oh the Gentiles will be first, then, and then, but then the Jews are like, no, this is not the true.
牧师从来没有试着要去解这个经。
I never really tried to interpret this verse.
一直到了两个星期以前 ，Pastor Philip 讲的时候。
Until about 2 weeks ago, when Pastor Philip preached.
然后 Pastor Philip 在讲的时候，他用保罗的一生。
And when Pastor Philip was preaching, he used the example of Paul's life.
然后。就在他分享的时候
So when he was sharing
我突然间明白
I understood
其实这一段经文在讲些什么
What this verse is talking about
我记得上一次牧师有讲因为圣灵就跟我说去看马太福音
So last time Holy Spirit told me to go read book of Matthew
如果马太福音第一章的一到十七节
Matthew 1:1-17
那很多人一想马太福音第一章不就是什么呢
And what's
讲耶稣的什么家谱
Matthew chapter 1 is talking about the genealogy of Jesus
他是从亚伯拉罕开始讲的
It started with Abraham
然后一直讲然后十四代然后到耶稣
And 14 generations till Christ
OK 然后圣灵又跟我说去看路加福音的三章的23-38
And then the Holy Spirit told me to look at Luke chapter 3:23
到三十八
to 38
OK 在这里也是讲到耶稣的家谱
Here also talk about the genealogy of Jesus
在圣经里面就是马太跟路加
So it's Mark and Luke
讲到耶稣的家谱
Talk about the genealogies of Jesus Christ
可是在马在路加这里讲的是从耶稣推回一直到亚当神的儿子
But it started with Jesus Christ and goes backward until the Adam, the son of God.
所以牧师要教弟兄姐妹来看，圣灵带我怎么来看，来回答这段经文。
So I want to show you how Holy Spirit led me to interpret this verse.
好，所以牧师要借我突然间，伸手就可以拿到一个 clock 变魔术，变出来了。
I have a clock here.
我们每个人都看到时钟。
You see this clock?
它总共有24小时，可是在上面就只有12。
So there are 12 numbers on the clock.
然后呢，如果我们以12是一个起初
，So if 12 is the beginning.
所以创世纪的第一章的第一节
，Genesis 1:1
说起初
，In the beginning，
神创造天地
，God created heaven.
所以神给了一个起初
，So God gave a beginning.
然后在这个起初的里面，就在这个12的里面，他完成了整个的创造。
So in this number 12, in 12, he finished all creations.
一个很重要的在创世纪的里面
，In Genesis, it's very important.
就是第一章
，It's chapter 1.
不是在第一章里面有一个很重要的
，There's something very important in chapter 1.
就是什么？神创造了万物，然后跟他造的人立约
That God created all things and he has a covenant with the man he created
然后他跟亚当说到神最原始赋予每一个人一个创造的目的
And he told Adam the purpose of all his creations
不是他
the purpose,
他创造这个人的目的
the purpose of that he created man
就是什么这个我们教会应该每一个都知道了吧生养众多
increase and multiply
生养众多遍满地面而且要治理这地
and have dominion over all the earth
OK 这是神给人一个最原始创造目的的一个使命
This is the original intent that God gave to men
所以牧师从以前就一直跟弟兄姐妹说其实要先去明白每一个人被赋予 的使命。
So that's why I keep on telling you guys, you have to understand your destiny, your assignment.
也就是
which means
第一个亚当所被赋予的。
That means the assignment that Adam was first given.
当这个首先的亚当被赋予了这个使命。
When this first Adam was given this assignment.
在神把创造万物，然后托付给他去，叫做什么？托管给他。
And then God created everything and have Adam have the dominion over everything.
可是亚当干嘛？第一个亚当
But
失败了。
But the first Adam failed.
Okay, 所以
So
整个圣经旧约的圣经
The whole Bible in Old Testament
在旧约的圣经
In Old Testament
是在预备这一个神造的人可以与神合而为一的显现
is to prepare men to be able to walk with God. It's the manifestation of that.
然后这个人就是
and this man is
就是幕后的亚当耶稣基督
is the last Adam, Jesus Christ.
如果我们十二是起初
if 12 is the beginning,
然后因为亚当堕落
because Adam fell,
所以整个的旧约都在预备以色列的百以色列一直不断的，你看见所有的先知的预言。
So you see the whole Old Testament, all the prophecy of the prophets.
然后这些君王所做的预表。
All the things that the kings did.
这些都是在预表着谁？耶稣基督。
This is all foreshadowing Jesus Christ.
就是道成肉身的耶稣基督。
The Word becoming flesh, Jesus Christ.
所以，如果我们用这个来看的话，从十二。
So starting from 12,
一直到六好了
until 6,
我们当作是旧约
let's say that's Old Testament.
所以以整个时间来看，就从亚伯拉罕
so starting in the time, so starting from Abraham,
然后从亚当堕落之后的他的世代
and from Adam after he fell his generations.
这整个都在预备着谁？耶稣基督这一个被杀的羔羊，在创世以前就已经被杀的羔羊要进入到舞台。
It's preparing Jesus Christ, the Word becoming flesh, the Lamb that was slain before the foundations of the world, is prepare him to come into the stage.
所以在这一个旧约的里面，有许多的人被呼召进来预备这个弥赛亚的再来。
So in Old Testament, many people are called to go into that time to prepare the coming of the Messiah.
然后每一个人都被赋予了什么？就像这里讲的，那个一钱，
so everyone
就是讲定了一钱。
So everyone is given like the parable, the one denarius.
也就是每一个，不论你是一二三，这中间的距离都是一样的。
Doesn't matter what number you are, one, two, three, all the distance is the same.
你就是要来预备这一个什么弥赛亚的再来。
You're coming to prepare the coming of the Messiah.
然后这样子，在这样的里面，我们就看见到弥赛亚再来之前，圣经说到的。在马太福音讲到是从亚伯拉罕
So before the coming of the Messiah in Matthew it says Abraham starting from Abraham
所以从亚伯拉罕
So starting from Abraham
一直到耶稣基督
till Jesus
弥赛亚的在道成肉身的耶稣基督
until the word becoming flesh
你看见了什么
What do you see
其实这里牧师今天用时钟的原因就让弟兄姐妹所谓的在前跟在后代表着是什么时间
So I used the example of clock to show that the first last and last first representing time
因为只有在时间里面才有在前跟在后
Because only in time when you have first and last
好所以如果我们的脑袋能够记清楚这整个的旧约都在预备谁的来临
So remember the whole Old Testament is preparing for who to come
耶稣基督
Jesus Christ
道成肉身的耶稣基督
The Word becoming flesh, Jesus Christ
所以这整个的预备从亚伯拉罕开始
So this whole preparation started from Abraham
然后开始一直不断的预备预备预备
And preparing, preparing, preparing
这中间有许多什么神所重用的先知
There are many prophets
还有包括君王还有大卫
David
这些人都是干嘛？都在预备这一个耶稣基督弥赛亚的来临。
All these people are preparing for the coming of the Messiah.
然后你就会发现说， 亚伯拉罕如果是一的话
，If Abraham is one，
然后这些的众先知、大祭司，这所有的亚不还摩西。都在这个的里面。
You see Moses, the priests, the prophets, they're all in those numbers.
在时间的里面。
They're in time.
然后在时间的里面。
In time.
到最后是谁迎接了耶稣基督的再来
who welcomed the coming of Jesus Christ?
谁？施洗约翰。
John the Baptist.
所以以时间来看。
So according to time.
所以牧师也回答了你的一个很重要的问题。
So I also answered one of your questions.
施洗约翰说：“看啊
，John the Baptist said, 'Look, behold,
神的羔羊除去世人罪孽的。
The Lamb of God taken away the sin of the man.'
然后耶稣说：‘凡妇人所生的。
’And Jesus said, the whatever the born of woman, whoever is born of woman,
没有一个大过约翰的。
No one is greater than John.
然后圣经还说到先知。”到先知的是讲先知吗？先知的预言到约翰就停止了。
And the Bible said the prophecy stopped at John the Baptist.
所以很多人讲哦，所以现在没有先知了。
So a lot of people say, oh no, there's no more prophets anymore.
可是如果你知道，对于耶稣基督的道成肉身的耶稣基督来说，施洗约翰就是最靠近这个六的这里。
So if you look according to the time, the coming of the Messiah at 6, John the Baptist is closest to that number 6.
所以包括谁？约瑟。
And Joseph.
包括玛利亚。
Mary.
他们夫妻带出耶稣，他们也比以前的亚伯拉罕更靠近谁？更靠近耶稣的再来。耶稣基督道成肉身的耶稣基督。
Joseph and Mary, they raised Jesus. They're even closer in time compared to Abraham.
因为他们见证也迎接了这位神的儿子 的出生
Because they testify and welcome the birth of Jesus Christ
所以你看见了什么在时间的里面
So in time
亚伯拉罕
Abraham
的确在神的呼召上面他们是在前的
Yes, when God called them, they're ahead, they're first
可是对于整个的弥赛亚的时间的来临道成肉身的耶稣基督他们却是在
But if you look at from the time frame of Jesus Christ coming in flesh, then they're the last.
这样明白吗
Do you understand?
所以你会说，其实牧师要说，这个是时间，不是人的努力。
This is time. This is not an effort of man.
所以为什么这个里头第一个进去的人说啊，我们整天受苦，是不是受什么受热？劳苦受热。
So the first worker who enters say, oh, they're borne the burden and the heat of the day. Because they're in time.
所以也的确
It's true.
要说在这个中间
In between all these,
发生了很多的事情
many
不是吗
many things happen,
整个的旧约都在预备什么道成肉身的耶稣基督
So the whole Old Testament is preparing the word becoming flesh, Jesus Christ.
是吗这中间我们有很多没有讲的牧师要说从亚伯拉罕之后是谁啊
Who's after Abraham?
不是啊从创世纪以后当然以撒然后雅各这个
Sorry,
重点是
sorry.
再来就进入到什么
After Abraham then what?
不是啊创世纪之后是什么
What's after Genesis?
出埃及记
Exodus
所以在出埃及记的里面牧师跳很快好吗我们就从一就跳到二了 OK 然后在第二就是什么创世、啊、不是出埃及记
And there's Exodus
在这里有四百年为奴
There are 400 years they're slaves
有旷野的四十年
And the wilderness for 40 years
然后还有整个去到迦南地还要面对耶利哥城
And then they enter into the land of Canaan and they face Jericho
然后之后还有谁大卫的出现
And then David
然后呢之后还有四百年
And then after that there are 400 years
旧约跟新约中间有四百年神是沉默的
And there's 400 years between Old Testament and New Testament that God was silent
就像之前Pastor Philip 有让弟兄姐妹去看到希伯来书十一章，我们也翻到那边希伯来书。我是盼望我们能够对照希伯来书十一章。
Let's look at Hebrews 11。
你就能够明白他们这里牧师所说的。
Then you'll be able to understand what I'm trying to say.
十一章的十三到三十八节，牧师今天没有时间让弟兄姐妹去看。
11, 13 through 38.
在这里讲到许多的人。
There are many people mentioned here.
在这里有讲到许多许多许多的人。
So many people were mentioned here.
从亚伯拉罕
Abraham,
然后以撒
Isaac,
然后还有摩西
Moses,
然后又讲到这些这耶利哥城
Jericho,
然后又讲到基甸巴拉参孙的这么多的人
Samson, all these people.
这些所有的人
All these people.
然后他在三十九节做一个总结。
And he concluded in verse 39.
这个上一次 Pastor Philip 有用。
Pastor Philip said it as well.
这些人都是因信得了美好的证据，却仍未得着所应许的。
And all these, having obtained a good testimony through faith, did not receive the promise.
第四十节
verse 40.
因为神给我们预备了更美的事。叫他们若不与我们同德，就不能完全。
God having provided something better for us, that they should not be made perfect apart from us.
所以到六
，So from six,
耶稣基督道成肉身
，We're becoming flesh, Jesus Christ.
亚伯拉罕看见
，Abraham saw.
所以这中间摩西，所有的人都看见了耶稣基督的即将的再来。
Moses and everyone in between, they saw the coming of Jesus Christ.
他们为主的名的缘故受了许多的逼迫。
For the name of Jesus, they are persecuted.
可是他们却没有能够在活着的时候去看见耶稣基督道成的肉身。
But when they were alive, they could not see the Word becoming flesh.
然后呢，到了耶稣那一个时刻的人
，until that the moment when Jesus was on the earth，
所以最靠近以妇人所生的先知来说，是谁最靠近？施洗约翰。
So John the Baptist was the one closest to Jesus.
耶稣的服事的里面，施洗约翰非常的重要。
In Jesus's ministry, John the Baptist was very important.
因为他在那里宣告出耶稣基督的身份，也见证耶稣基督是神的儿子。
Because he was there to declare the identity of Jesus Christ and then to testify for his ministry.
所以耶稣才会说，凡妇人所生的，没有一个人是大过约翰的。
And so that's why Jesus said, whoever born of a woman, no one's greater than John the Baptist.
因为就算旧约所有的先知，他们都只是远远的看见耶稣，而没有真正亲眼见到耶稣。
So even all the prophets in the Old Testament, they did not physically see Jesus. They only saw him from afar.
只有施洗约翰
Only John the Baptist.
这位先知
This prophet.
他亲眼见证了这一个神的儿子道成的肉身。
He seen with his own eyes that the word becoming flesh.
所以
so,
凡妇人所生没有大过约翰的。
Whoever is born of the woman, no one's greater than John the Baptist.
可是在天国里面
but in the kingdom of God,
那最小的也比他要大。
The smallest shall be greater than John.
牧师之前有讲过这篇信息。
I've talked about this before.
为什么
Why?
为什么为什么在天国里面那最小的也都要比施洗约翰大？为什么
？Why in the kingdom of heaven everyone's greater than John the Baptist？
我考试了
，It's a test。
有谁能够见证耶稣基督的复活啊 ？Pastor Philip 讲见证耶稣基督的复活。
Pastor Philip said to testify the resurrection of Jesus。
因为耶稣基督来了之后
，Because after Jesus came，
他把所有的祭司的服事。
All the work of the priest, the ministries of priest,
还有先知的服事
and the ministry of the prophet,
做了一个极其重大的改变
He did a great change, a transformation.
为什么？因为就算再小的
even the smallest,
在神的国里，他都是什么？耶稣基叫耶稣基督从死里复活者的灵所居住的所在。
Because in the kingdom of heaven, even the smallest, it is the temple for the word of spirit that raised Jesus from the dead.
所以
，so
不是先知的预言不见了。
It's not that the prophecy had gone away.
而是因为耶稣基督来了之后，从六开始，耶稣所做的一切。都改变了旧约的的影儿
Because after six, after Jesus came,
不应该说改变，他显明了完成了旧约。
Jesus completed Old Testament.
也就是其实神从创世纪一个很重要的心意，就是神与人，人与神合而为一。
Because the heart of God in Genesis, one thing very important is God with man, man with God, two becoming one.
然后不是只是哦，我跟神合而为一了，而是要透过你跟我在这全地来掌权。
And not just two becoming one, but through you and I, we shall reign on the earth.
所以这是神给每一个人。就算你生下来，就算你还不认识耶稣基督，这样的托付也在他的身上。
So even if you don't know Jesus Christ, when you're born, this assignment is also in you.
因为我们都是按着神的形象跟样式所造的。
Because we're created according to His image and likeness.
所以每一个人都按着神所领受的这样子的在往前来预备。
So everyone's preparing accordingly.
这样明白吗？好，所以再来，我们就到了新约喽。
Okay, so now we're in New Testament.
耶稣基督已经道成肉身了。
Jesus has already become flesh.
那请问我们现在在预备什么？
So what are we preparing then?
圣经上面讲，我们每逢吃这饼、喝这杯，是表明主的死，只等到他的再来。
The Bible said that we're eating this bread, drinking this cup, is to proclaim his death till he comes.
就像旧约
，just like the Old Testament.
神的时间概念是完全完是一个圆是一个圆圈。
The concept of God's time is that it's a circle.
所以是起跟终是在同一点。
So the beginning and the end is one place, one point.
所以
，so
在旧约隐儿是预备弥赛亚。
So in Old Testament is foreshadowing the Messiah.
所以这些亚伯拉罕、摩西他们。在呼召的上面是在前的
So Abraham, Moses, in terms of calling, they're first.
可是在耶稣基督时间的来临的里面，他们却是在后的
But in the time of Jesus coming onto the earth, they're last.
所以施洗约翰反而是最近的
So John the Baptist is actually the closest.
这样明白吗？好，所以道成肉身的耶稣已经来了
Okay, so we're becoming flesh, Jesus Christ is here.
所以道成肉身的耶稣基督的那个时刻，所有的人都比这个前面的都在什么在前了。
So whoever's in living at the time when Jesus was in his flesh, they're all ahead of the people who live in the past.
好，那我们现在要预备耶稣基督的再来。
Okay, so now we're preparing the second coming of Jesus.
也就是又整个时间来说，又要回到什么神原本创造的心意的里面。
So in terms of time, now we're returning to the original intent of God.
也就是神的帐幕在人间。
It's the tabernacle of God is with men.
所以神与人，人与神的再一次的合而为一，一定会被彰显出来。
So God and man and man and God, the two becoming one, it will be manifested.
好，所以从耶稣的再来，耶稣再来，他在世上。他招了十二个门徒。
So when Jesus was on the earth, he called the 12 disciples.
然后十二个门徒之后
，and after the 12 disciples,
他又在一个大光的里面去呼召了谁？保罗、扫罗。
He called Saul in the great light.
所以以时间点来说
，so in terms of timeline,
对于耶稣基督的再来
，for the second coming of Jesus,
保罗
，Paul
是在后，可是他们却是在前的。
He was last, but they're the first as well.
所以对于十二个使徒来说，他们对道成肉身的耶稣基督是最近的。
So for the 12 disciples, they're close,
最前的。
They're the first, closest to Jesus in flesh.
可是对于耶稣基督的再来，你跟我就又是在前了。
But for the second coming of Jesus Christ, you and I are ahead of others.
所以我们是非常重要的。
So we are very important.
因为我们比十二个使徒，甚至比保罗要更靠近耶稣基督的再来。
Because compared to the twelve disciples, even Paul, we're even closer to the second coming of Jesus Christ.
照耶稣说的，我们要比他做更大的事。
Like what Jesus said, we shall do greater things than him.
所以照说，以圣经来看，保罗的确比这一些十二个使徒做更大的事。
So you'll see that Paul did greater things than the 12 disciples.
所以牧师也期待。
So I expect.
因为我们即将靠近耶稣基督的再来。
Because we're closer to the second coming of Jesus.
你跟我不是没有目标的，在世上晃来晃去的。
You and I are not aimlessly walking on the earth.
我们不是赤拳打空气，没有方向。
We're not beating the air without direction.
我们也不是吹一个没有定向的号角。
We're not just blowing the trumpet without direction.
我们乃是知道我们是在预备耶稣基督的再来。
We know we're preparing for the second coming of Jesus Christ.
所以我们的孩子，每一个现在在地上爬的，甚至在母腹里面的，他们都极其的重要。
So all our children, you know, the one that's crawling on the ground, even in the womb, they're all very important.
为什么？因为他们比我们这些做祖父母辈的更靠近耶稣基督的再来。
Because they're even closer to the second coming of Jesus compared to the grandparents.
但是以神来看
，But in the eyes of God,
我们都在一个世代。
We're all in one generation.
如果旧约十二一直到六，这是一个世代。
If 12 to 6 is one generation.
如果我们从耶稣的道成肉身一直到耶稣的再来。
If we're becoming flesh until the second coming of Jesus Christ,
那我们也是一个世代。
It's another generation.
所以我们每一个人都很重要。
So every one of us is important.
甚至你现在已经年老发白了，活在这个世上。
Even though you're young, you're old, and you're wise, and you're still living in this world,
你也很重要。
You're still important.
因为你在整个耶稣基督的再来的里面，你是有份的。
Because you partake in the second coming of Jesus.
Amen. 所以上次。玉华牧师用的叫做接力的概念。
So last time Pastor Philip used the example of a relay.
然后每一个人都要承接那个棒子。
So everyone shall take the baton.
然后呢，可是对牧师来说，似乎看起来我们是从我们的祖先沉传下来。
So seems like we're carrying it onward from our ancestors.
也的确是，因为整个如果不是有前面的一二三，你怎么能够到六呢？
Which is also true because without 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, how can you get to 6?
所以第二不能够说我不需要一。
Two cannot say I don't need one.
因为我们都是因着别人家成全了我们。
Because we're here because other people had fulfilled for us.
阿们。所以牧师要说
，So I want to say，
从刚刚我们回到刚刚马太福音的二十章一到十六节。
Let's go back to Matthew 20。
在这里，牧师觉得我们可以学习到很重要的事情。
We can learn something important here。
也就是这些信仰的伟人，在我们生命的当中
，All these great men in our
在我们生命的里面
in our lives,
包括这一位这十二位使徒
including the 12 disciples,
包括写了新约圣经三分之二的保罗
including Paul who wrote most of the New Testament,
他们都成了在前的
they're first,
因为我们都成了在后的
because we became the last,
因为对时间点来说不是你跟我的努力
because in terms of time frame, it's not by our effort,
而是因为我们生逢其时
but because we happen to be born in this time,
所以我们真的很重要
so we're very important,
我盼望每一个人都要珍惜自己的性命
I hope we can all treasure our lives,
因为我们都很重要
because we're all very important,
因为牧师就要来解释什么叫做被招的人多，选上的人少。
Because now I want to explain what does it mean for many are called but few chosen.
因为所有的人
，because everyone
都像亚当一样，被神赋予了一个目的在他生命的当中。
Because everyone's like Adam, they're given an assignment in their life.
就是要去生养众多，遍满地面，而且要治理这地。
To increase, multiply, and have dominion over the earth.
可是在这一个呼召的里面
But in this calling
牧师要说的确有许多就像大卫
Indeed, there are many like David
有很多就像主的十二个门徒
Some are like the 12 disciples
也就像是保罗
Some like Paul
他们的确被拣选有特别的使命在他们生命的当中
They're chosen to have a special calling in their lives
他们要能够去预备主的百姓来预备耶稣基督的再来。
They're preparing the people of God to prepare the coming of Jesus Christ.
可是在这一个拣选的里面
But in this choosing,
我们从旧约一直到新约
From Old Testament to New Testament,
牧师真的觉得有很重要的要在这里来做提醒。
I would like to remind you something important.
所以上一次 Pastor Philip 用保罗的一生
Last time Pastor Philip used Paul's life
保罗的一生就是预备耶稣基督的再来。
Paul's life is to prepare the coming of Jesus.
也因着他预备耶稣的再来，所以你跟我现在才有这些保罗的书信，可以在我们的生命里面成为我们极大的祝福。
Because he was preparing for the coming of Jesus Christ, so you and I can read his epistles and become a blessing to us.
的确，很多人我们都被呼召。
Yes, many of us are called.
因为我们就是要去活出神与人、人与神合而为一的实际。
Because God wants us to live out the reality of God and men and men in God.
可是偏偏
，But
这不是一个很那么容易就有办法去完成在生命的当中。
This is not easy to finish in our lives.
有许多的人
，Many people
的确有这样的呼召。
Yes, they are called.
可是他们基本并因为没有认出
But they did not recognize
我要说你会说牧师可是我不知道我的呼召是什么
You can say, oh pastor, I don't know what my calling is
不像你啊你牧师你就知道说你呼召你是在教会的里面释放神的话
And it's like, oh, not like you You know you're called to be a pastor to release the word of God
可是牧师要说以神的呼召最原始的这个地就在你自己的身上。
But the original calling, the original intent is in you.
神所要你的就是在这个称为你的地上也要掌权。
God wants you to reign in this land that call you. He wants you to reign.
你要在你的身上带下这个掌权。
You shall bring out the reign in yourself.
这是你至少可以负责的地方。
You are responsible for this land.
所以牧师是要说，每一个人都应该要负责他自己所被托付的地。
So you're responsible for you this earth.
阿门。至少我不敢说你要去掌管多大的领域。
I'm not saying you shall, you know, reign over how much territory.
可是至少这属于你的这块地，你是可以掌权的。
But this earth that's you, you should be able to reign over it.
然后你所结婚，你所带的家庭，你是可以掌权的。
And after you get married, the family that you have, you should be able to reign.
阿门。这是神最少最少给我们的领域。
This is the minimal territory that God has given us.
然后你所工作的地方
，where you work.
然后从这个工作的地方带到更远的地方
，and from where you work to further.
但是牧师要说，至少在我们这一块地上
，But at least in this earth，
我是被呼召而且拣选要在我这块地上掌权的。
You're called and chosen to reign on this earth. That's you.
但是在圣经里面，旧约是婴儿
，But the Old Testament is just foreshadowing.
所以让我们学习到许多的人都被神呼召，可是他们却干嘛？却是失败了。
So we saw that many are called in the Old Testament, but many are also failed.
所以我们要能够透过每一次的信息来学习。
So through every message we learn.
我们不仅被召
Not only are we called.
我们更是能够被选上，然后去完成神所给我的托付。
Not only are we called, but also can be chosen to finish the assignment God has given us.
而不是像这一个年轻富有的少年官忧忧愁愁的走。
And it's not like this rich young ruler who left sorrowful.
所以牧师要说，当然我相信耶稣，因为看着这个年轻富有的少年官。
Of course, when Jesus saw this rich young ruler,
他忧忧愁愁走了。
He went away sorrowful.
所以我相信耶稣在那里是感叹的。
So I'm sure Jesus was sighing.
被召的人多，选上的人少。
Many are called, but few chosen.
其实只是一个回应而已。
It's just a response.
只是一个回应说主我拿起这样的权柄来治理我这地而已
It's just a response that yes Lord I take up the authority to reign over this earth
可是有许多的人却在这一个选择的上面忧忧愁愁的离开了
But many people choose to go away sorrowfully
所以牧师要说从刚刚牧师所读的经文
So what I just read
牧师觉得我们可以学习到第一个就是我们的态度
We can learn number one our attitude
上次 Pastor Philip 讲到成全
Last time Pastor Philip said to fulfill
也就是我们的生命是因着别人家先立的根基
Our life is here because someone else laid a foundation
你是六
You're
可是是因为前面有一二三四五
You're here at six but because there's one through five there
所以 我们的生命要学习什么？去成全。
So our life should learn to fulfill others.
我们乃是因为别人在生命中付上了代价。
Other people paid the price.
所以使得我们今天可以站在这样的时刻。
So that we can stand in this moment.
所以我们要能够带着这样子的成全去走我们的生命的道路。
So we should also fulfill to walk our path.
也就是我们是六啊。
So、
所以我们愿意去成全七八九十十一。
So we're also to we're willing to fulfill 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
阿门。所以我们愿意，因为别人成全了我们，使我们可以站在这样的根基上。
Because other fulfilled us, so we can stand on this foundation.
就像保罗所说的
，Just like what Paul said.
我们要像一个聪明的工头，在这样的根基上面去建造。
We shall be a smart worker and laid to build on the foundation.
然后在这样子的里面，你看，是因为他们为主的名的殉道的果实，所以使得我们今天有这样子的圣经的经文可以在我们的面前。
Because they were the martyr and because of their fruit, so we can have this Bible in front of us.
我后来有再去查，保罗在59岁的时候，被砍头。
So I looked that up. Paul was beheaded when he was 59.
所以牧师真的觉得是因为他们付上了生命的代价。
They paid the price with their lives.
所以牧师每一次读到马太福音的第一章，
So every time I read Matthew chapter 1,
或者路加福音的第三章，
or Luke 3,
我看见耶稣的家谱的时候，
I see the genealogy of Jesus Christ.
我不是只是说哦，看见这些人名。
I didn't just see names.
你知道每一次我看见所有这些人名的时候，
Whenever I see all these names,
我都倍感亲切。
I feel so close to them.
因为是他们来成全了今日的我。
Because they came to fulfill me to where I am today.
我看见整个世代的成全在这么简短的这几节的里面。
I see the fulfilling of the generations in all these verses.
然后我也看见世代的祝福在这么几节的经文的里面。
I see the generational blessings in these verses as well.
然后这每每都会提醒我要去成全。
And always remind me to fulfill others as well.
我们不是只是自己吃喝然后就睡觉。
It's not just for us to eat and drink and go to sleep.
我们要能够去成全。
But be able to fulfill others.
另一个更重要的
More importantly,
就是要谦卑。
Is to humble.
也就是我们乃是吃别人家劳碌的果实。
We're eating the fruit that other labored.
有一句中文
，There's a Chinese saying
叫做前人种树，后人乘凉。
The first person planted and the last person get the shade.
对，前人种树，后人乘凉。所以就像这个葡萄园的里面工作的人
，Just like this vineyard.
我要说前面的人。
The first workers,
因为他们劳苦受热
because they bore the burden of the day and the heat,
所以我们才有办法有不一样的果实在你跟我生命的当中
so that we can bear a different fruit.
当我们拿到了圣经
when we have the Bible,
你知道现在所有的话都写在里面了
you know all the words are written.
可是你能够知道，当亚伯拉罕被神呼召的时候，他出去什么都不知道吗
？But imagine when Abraham, when he was called, when he left, he didn't know anything.
真的，他是在这样的信心的里面走出去。
He really was walking in faith.
不知道往哪里。
He didn't know where he was going.
只是神告诉他说：“往我要你去的地方。
God just told him, go where I tell you to.
可是你跟我现在
But you and I,
我们却已经知道亚伯拉罕的一生了。
We knew Abraham's whole life.
当他年99岁
When he was 99,
他什么都不行的时候，圣经说他可以在神的面前成为完全的人。
When he couldn't do anything, the Bible said that he was perfect before the Lord.
你觉得亚伯拉罕年99岁的时候，他能够有这样的启示吗
？Do you think Abraham can have this revelation when he was 99?
可是你跟我却已经有这样的启示了。
But you and I already have this revelation.
所以，就算你现在面对到生命极其的软弱
，So even if you experiencing such great difficulties in such weaknesses,
神的应许跟神 跟你所经历的是截然相反的。
The promises and what you're going through is completely different.
你也能够知道说，因为亚伯拉罕这样的时候，神反而出现。
And you knew what happened to Abraham when he was 99 in such a time, God showed up.
所以我也一定可以，我只要再坚持这么一点点，神也一定会出现。
So if I'm just persisted a little longer, God will show up.
你跟我已经有神的话了。
You and I already have the word of God.
而且是每一个人生命都完全记载在这个里面。
And everyone's life is written in here.
耶稣
Jesus.
保罗
Paul.
保罗的一生也都写在里面了。
Paul's whole life is written here.
所以我们在读的
So when we read it,
是让我们知道，因为他们这些信仰的伟人，使得我们今天能够去站在他们的肩膀走得更远。
Because of these great people, so we can stand on their shoulders and see even further.
所以在哥林多后书三章五节
In 2 Corinthians 3:5,
这里是大家都知道的。
We're very familiar.
好，第五节
，verse five.
亚波罗算什么？保罗算什么？无非是执事，照主所赐给他们个人的引导，你们相信。啊啊啊！我对不起，对不起，我以为我只能讲成前书。I'm sorry. OK.难怪我说奇怪，为什么跟我想的不一样呢 ？OK， 好，哥林多
，Let's read it again。
哥林多后书三章五节 ，I'm so sorry。
Second Corinthians 3:5。
这个好，后书 ，I'm sorry， 后书。
Second Corinthians，
并不是我们凭自己能承担什么事，我们所能承担的乃是出于神。
Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think of anything as being from ourselves, but our sufficiency is from God.
也就是我们之所以今天能够承担预备耶稣基督的再来
is that we're sufficient to carry on what to prepare the second coming of Jesus Christ.
并不是因为你跟我有多大的能耐
It's not because of us.
多大的
It's not because of our ability.
因为我们得救是本乎恩，也因着信。
Because our salvation is because of faith, through faith.
我们只不过是因着神的恩典，在时间的里面比他们后面进来而已。
Just because in the time point we're entering later.
所以我们只不过在时间的里面，我们能够去衡量他们所劳苦的结果而已。
So because in time we can enjoy what they labored.
所以我们要能够什么更加的谦卑
So we should humble ourselves even more
因为真的不是因为你跟我有更大的能耐可以比保罗做更大的事
Because it's not that we have even more ability than Paul
而是因为我们在时间点上接近耶稣基督的再来
Because in time we're closer to the second coming of Jesus
就一样包括这样子的启示其实牧师以前从来不知道
Even this revelation I just talked about
什么在前的在后在后的在前我从来不去伤脑筋
First, last, last, first I didn't know I didn't think too much about it
可是为什么我现在有这样的启示
But why do I have such revelations now?
是因为接近耶稣基督的再来
Because we're even closer to the second coming
不是因为我张运凡比别人家更属灵更靠近神
It's not that I'm more spiritual or closer to God
而是我只不过是在这一个靠近耶稣的再来的时间里面更靠近了
But because I'm even closer to the time point where Jesus is coming again
所以透过保罗透过这些圣经里面每一个神所呼召的仆人
So through Paul, through all the servants in the Bible
我们知道我们要能够谦卑来完成这个阶段我们所被赋予的使命
We know we shall humble and carry on the assignment
按着神的给我们的恩不断的去长大成熟
According to the grace that God has given us, continue to grow and mature
昨天牧师讲到
Yesterday I talked about
我们不是只是把神给我们的才干埋在地底下
We're not just burying our talents under the ground
我们乃是要至少要能够去做生意
At least to do something, some business or something
不是因为圣经上面讲的这个 occupy
The Bible said to occupy
这个 occupy 的意思就是 occupation 嘛，就是你的工作嘛。
It's your occupation. It's to occupy.
所以也意思就是你要能够去做生意得利。
So you have to be able to occupy and make profits.
可是 occupy 在英文里面还有去占领得着的意思。
But occupy in English just means to take over.
所以牧师要说。
So I would like to say,
在基督徒的生命打赢胜仗没有问题。
So in Christian's life to win a war, yeah, no problem.
可是神不是只是要我们打赢。
But God didn't just want to have us to have victory in a war.
因为耶稣基督已经得胜了。
Because Jesus Christ has already won.
可是他重要的是要我们能得地为业。
But he wants us to take over and to have it as our inheritance.
所以在我们被呼召的地。
So on the territory that we're called,
我们一定要站在那里去 possess.
We shall be there to possess.
我们一定要得到那一地。
We shall possess the land.
我们要靠着主征战得胜。
And then to have victory over.
所以在你这块地。
So in this earth, you.
不是只是打赢。
It's not just to have the victory.
而是要攻克己身，叫身服我。
It's to be.
OK， 攻克己身，我等一下后面再讲吧。那个经文 ，OK， 意思就是像保罗说的，你一定要严严的制服你这个身体。
It's to discipline this body, this earth，
然后让这个身体能够服在神的掌管的下面。
Let this body to be under the control, under the authority of Jesus。
你全身的每一个细胞都活在神旨意畅行无阻的里面。
Every cell of your body is living under the word of God。
这个叫做占领。
This is occupy。
阿们，所以牧师要说，我们每一个人的态度都要学习，像圣经在使徒行传十三章三十六节
，Acts 13:36，
这一节其实牧师非常的喜欢，因为每一次我都用这个来提醒我自己。
I always use this to remind myself。
十三章的三十六节
，Acts 13:36，
好。大卫在世的时候遵行了神的旨意就睡了，或义，这小字，大卫按神的旨意服侍了他那一世的人就睡了。
So here in verse 36, for David, after he had served his own generation by the will of God, in Chinese, this is a small font, saying, David, according to the will of God, served his generation, and he fell asleep.
这一句给我很，每一次我都会用这个来提醒我自己。
I always use this verse to remind myself.
就是让我自己学习谦卑。
So that I can learn to be humble.
也就是在我们的一生的当中。
That in our lives.
我不去求下一个世代。
I don't ask for the next generation.
我求的乃是在我这个世代，我能够按神的心意去服侍我那一世代的人，然后我就忠心，之后我就睡了。
That I can serve my generation according to God's will, and then I can fall asleep and sleep,
and go back to heaven. Okay, 然后就在对我来说，这个是很大的提醒。
For me, this is a great reminder.
就是大卫，他是君王。
David, he's a king.
所以你千万不需要在边，哎呀，没有主啊，我不能够成为君王，哎呀，我不配。
So don't be like, oh God, I can't be the king, I'm not worthy.
真实的谦卑
，the true humbleness，
就是神托付你，你是君王，你就站在君王的角色去服侍那一世代的人。
If God give you an assignment and you call you to be the king, then you stand as a king and minister your generation.
Amen.所以对我来说，这才是真实的谦卑。
So that's the true humbleness.
神叫你成为什么，你就成为什么。
You become whatever God called you to be.
那边，哎呀，我不配，哎呀，我根本不配，哎呀，我这样子，主啊，我，可能别人比我更合适吧。
You may say, "Oh, I'm not worthy. Maybe someone else is, you know, better suited."
牧师最讨厌这种人。
I hate that.
Okay. 其实神既然托付你，你就站在那里啊。
Since God has called you, then you just stand there.
没有错，我们都不见得是成熟。
Sure, we're not always mature.
可是我们却在成熟的过程的里面去荣耀神的名。
But in the process of maturing, we glorify the name of God.
而且我要说大卫。
And David.
他不仅服侍他那一世代的人。
Not only did he minister his generation.
你看见他更是预备什么？预备了所罗门建圣殿所有的材料。
He even prepared all the materials Solomon needed to build the temple.
你知道我看见了在大卫的生命的里面。
In David's life.
也就是他服侍他那一世代的。
He ministered his generation.
然后他很有心意要为耶和华神建殿。
He had such a heart to build a temple for God.
结果没想到神说不是你，是你的儿子。
But God said, no, it's not you, but Solomon.
然后他没有在那边说主啊我岂不是为你的名是如此的劳苦吗
He didn't say Oh God did I not work You know work so hard for your name
我岂不是这样的心要为你建殿吗
I had such a heart to build a temple for you
他没有
He didn't say that
他阿们神所说的
He amen whatever God said
神说是你的儿子不是你
God said it's your son not you
然后他并没有说好那儿子，我就看你怎么办。
He didn't just say, "Okay, my son, then I'll see what you're gonna do."
他反而预备所有一切的什么材料。
But instead, he prepared all the materials.
所以这是真正的谦卑跟成全。
So that's true humbleness and to fulfill.
就是我按着神的旨意去服侍我这一世代的。
It's according to the will of God, I serve that generation.
然后我愿意。在为我下一个世代去做预备这些的材料
and even more for the next generation prepare the materials
Amen 所以我要说这是一个极其重要的态度在我们生命的当中
This is a very important attitude in our lives
但是时间的关系牧师没有办法再往下了 OK 再来我本来 要分享的是生命
Next I was going to share about life
就是一个十字架的回应
The response to the cross
十字架的对付
the working of the cross
然后还有十字架的彰显
And the manifestation of the cross
下次我再说了 okay,
I'll talk about it next time
所以牧师要说这个十字架在我们生命的当中很重要
Cross in our life is very important
因为除了我们的态度之外
Not only is it our attitude
我们的生命必须是一个十字架全然的彰显
But our life shall be a manifestation of the cross
所以牧师要说这真的很重要
So it's very important
所以我们下个星下不是下个星期下一次牧师再来希望大家不要忘记今天所说的
So next time when I preach don't forget what I said today
然后下次我再来把这十字架如何活出基督给带给弟兄姐妹
So next time I'll bring out this message, this cross, how to live out Jesus Christ and I'll share it with you guys
在我们生命的当中十字架真的非常重要
In our lives, cross is very important
你的一辈子都必须拥抱十字架
All your life you have to embrace the cross
因为圣经之所以说被召的人多选上的人少
The Bible says that many are called but few chosen
你跟我绝对没有借口了
You and I have no excuse.
因为我们有整本的圣经。
We have the whole Bible.
所以你跟我。
So you and I.
在十字架上面的功课却是被要求更严格的了。
We're being required even more on the work of, on the work of cross.
所以你不是只是被召，也能够被选上，而且完成神的托付，就在于十字架。
You, not only are you called, but can be chosen, it's because of the cross.
旧约有许多的这些先祖辈。
There are many ancestors in the Old Testament.
属灵啦，属灵的先祖。
Spiritual ancestors.
因为他们没有耶稣基督的十字架
They didn't have the cross of Jesus Christ
所以的确他们成了影儿成了我们的一个镜子在我们的眼前
So they're a foreshadowing there are mirrors before us
所以盼望我们能从他们的生命去学习这十字架的功课
So I hope we can learn the lesson of the cross in them, from them
Amen 所以感谢赞美主牧师真的说盼望我们能够更加的谦卑
So I hope that we can truly humble
然后也能够去成全
And to fulfill
因为我们不是只是我们不是只是我们而已
Because we're not just here, us here.
我们在预备耶稣基督的再来
We're preparing the second coming of Jesus.
将会有许多的人在我们的后面
Many people will come after us.
所以我们能够预备我们自己
So that we can prepare ourselves.
我们有可能是那一个种树的然后后面乘凉的
We may be the one who's planting the tree but the others will enjoy the shade.
我们可能就像保罗一样
We may be like Paul.
可是神对于每一个世代神所呼召的仆人
But for everyone that God called in every generation.
忠心
Be faithful.
所以忠心在神所托付你的
Be faithful to what God has assigned you
然后我们存着感恩的心
And with a thankful heart
承接从世代来的祝福
Carry the generational blessings
然后为了我们过去这一些人而献上感恩
And be thankful for the people who came before us
因为我们是在时间的里面
Because we're in time
可是神看待时间
But when God see time
十二到十二
12 and 12
都是一样的
It's the same
所以所得的奖赏
So the reward
是根据神在每一个格子的里面神所呼召你去做的
It's according to what God called you to do
所以我们能够带着这样的心继续的前行
So that we can carry and continue to move forward
在前的在后
first last
在后的在前
last first
所以愿我们透过今天的信息能够学习
so through today's message I hope we can learn
好感谢赞美主
so praise the Lord
我们要为我们的奉献来先做一个祷告然后我们再让大家从 Zoom 开始来回应然后也一同来祷告
We'll pray for our offerings and we'll go to Zoom.
感谢主安妮塔，谢谢。好，小心。好。我们稍微等一下好所以把你的奉献就算你在家中也一样的举起
Lift up your offerings even if you're at home
来感谢主好来把我们的奉献带到主的面前
Bring the offerings before the Lord
在天上的父神我再一次奉耶稣基督的名
Father in heaven the name of Jesus
主每一次撒种的时候
Every time we sow the seed
主我们不是只是看见我们
We didn't just see us
主我们看见那再来的世代
But we see the coming generations
主谢谢你给我们这样子的榜样
Thank you for giving us an example
就像大卫一样
Just like David
服侍他那一世代的人
He ministered his generation
可是他也愿意去成全他下一个世代
And yet he also fulfilled the next generation
所以主我们将我们的所有摆在主你的手中
We give all we have into your hands
我们凭信心将一切所有都献上
By faith we give you everything
主我们相信
We believe
这五饼二鱼
The five loaves and two bread
是带来是无限的
Bring forth infinity
谢谢主
Thank you Lord
愿主你自己亲自祝福每一个甘心乐意奉献的弟兄姐妹
Bless everyone who offer willingly
在这样全地都震动的时刻
In a time when the whole earth is shaking
让世人看见我们是属你的百姓
The whole earth see that we belong to you
在极深黑暗的时候
In that deep darkness
让我们成为那一个光
That we shall be the light
让我们成为耶稣基督和神你的话的见证人。
Let us be the witness of your word.
Be the testimony of Jesus Christ and your word. 谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.